Welcome back to the third tutorial on NetLogo. What we now want to do is give you some training in basic math done with NetLogo. So we have already defined a variable called result and given this the value 1. Now let's change this a bit. Let's give it the value 0. And let's eliminate for a moment the print, and let's define two other variables called a with a value of 14 and b with a value of 6. And now what you want to do is you want to influence result in a way that it takes up the result of the calculation a plus b. So you want to do it like in the following. You'd calculate a plus b and assign whatever comes out from this to result. You must consider two different concepts. To define a variable means creating it, and to assign a value to a variable means filling it. So if you want to fill a previously defined variable, then we use the expression set, then comes the variable name, and then comes with what I want to fill it, with the result from a plus b. So now you do assign a plus b to result. And now you can print this result again. And if I'm correct, then this should... Oh, let's press simple calculations. This should be 20 correct. So this is sort of ugly, because what you really want to do is to show a text before, and maybe you want to show a text afterwards. The construct you can use in order to make this possible is square bracket word, then comes some string, some sentence, which means the result of space, then comes the first variable you want to display, a, then comes another sentence, and then comes another variable, like b, and then comes the sentence is, and then comes the result, and then the bracket closes. So this is a special command. This word command ties together a set of variables and sentences you give it. So let's look it up by using help lookup in NetLogo dictionary, and it says that the bracket could not be found, and it suggests that I should open the NetLogo dictionary, and I say yes, please open this. Then I'm using the alphabetical index to go to W, and then I search for word. Okay, I've now searched with Control F, which is maybe quicker. And now I'm pressing word, and here it says concatenates inputs together. Okay, so long thing short, let's try this now. I'm pressing simple calculations, and it says the result of 14 and 6 is 20. That's nice. So this is how we want to do it. So now you can do some advanced math. You can define result as 10, and so The result is already defined, therefore I have to use set to fill it with the new value 10. And then I can set result, I can fill result with whatever comes out when I multiply it by itself. So set result to the result of multiplying result by result. And then I'm again printing something. Multiplying result by result gives, and then result. Let's see if this works. So there is now a typo inside here, and NetTogo warns me that this is somehow misspelled. You have always to make a space between operators and the variable. So now if I check, everything will be correct. And let's execute this. Multiplying result by result gives 100. Okay, so this is it for the calculations. And of course you can do lots more. You can have dividers, subtractions, multiplications, additions, and so on. And if you're interested in what you can use, you can just turn over to it would be operators, maybe it's in keywords, or is it in math? It's in math. So here, arithmetical operators, and there are certain operators here that you could just look at. So we are not going into detail here. I'm only writing divided, minus, multiplication, and plus are possible, among others. So, in the next lesson, we are going to see that I can have a list as variable, whatever that means. And we are going to loop through that list and print out each element of the list. So thank you for this part of the tutorial, and see you next time.